The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 8th chapter, text number 15 through 20, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in October of 1966 in New York.
Mahupita Sunajjanma Dukkhalayam Athasatam Napnumanti Mahatmana Sangsiddhim Paramangataha. This verse we have been discussing on Friday. Krishna said that anyone who comes to me, of course Krishna is everywhere, but still, he has got his abode. The difference between Krishna and ordinary human being or ordinary living being is that we can remain at one place, but Krishna, goloka eva nivasati akhila atma bhuta, although he has got his abode in the transcendental kingdom, which is called Goloka Vrindavan. The Vrindavan city from where I have come, this Vrindavan is called Bhoma Vrindavan. Bhoma Vrindavan means the same Vrindavan descended on this earth. Just like Krishna descends on this earth out of his own internal potency, similarly, his dhamma or his abode also descends, the Vrindavan dhamma. Or, in other words, when Krishna descends on this earth, he manifests himself in that particular land. Therefore, that land is so sacred, Vrindavan. But Krishna has his own abode. And Krishna says, anyone who comes to my abode, mamupetta, punarjanma, dukkhalayam asasatam, he does not get again rebirth in this material world, which is full of threefold misery. Dukkhalayam asasatam. Nāpnuvanti. Why? Because Mahatmana, they are called Mahatma. Perhaps you have heard the name, this word, Mahatma. Our leader, Mahatma Gandhi, he was known as Mahatma. But Mahatma is not the title of a politician. Mahatma here, Mahatma means the first class Krishna conscious man who is eligible to enter into the abode of Krishna. He is called Mahatma. Mahatmana. And the Mahatmana's perfection is this, to prepare in this life, in this nice human form of life, with all facilities of nature. We can command over the nature. We can utilize the nature to our best interest. The animals cannot. So, all these facilities should be utilized for becoming a Mahatma or becoming eligible to enter into the kingdom of Krishna. Because if we can do that, then there is no more birth in this material world, which is full of threefold misery. We have several times discussed what are these threefold miseries, but every one of you know that somewhere or other we are in miserable condition, either pertaining to the mind or to this body or natural disturbance or from other friends or other animals. So there is always some kind of misery inflicted upon us. That is the situation of this material world. Krishna says that this is a place. You cannot avoid this misery. They are meant for that. Unless the miseries are there, you cannot come to the Krishna consciousness. That is an impetus and help to elevate you to Krishna consciousness. An intelligent person, he can think that I do not want miseries, but the miseries are inflicted upon me by force. Nobody wants. Then he should question, why these miseries are inflicted upon me by force? Unfortunately, the modern civilization, they set aside, let me suffer. Let me cover it by some intoxication, that's all. You see? But as soon as the intoxication is over, again I am in the same point. So this is not the solution. You cannot make a solution of the miseries of your life by artificial intoxication. That is not possible. You have to make the solution by this Krishna consciousness. If you always remain in Krishna consciousness, then gradually you will develop and you will be able to leave or quit your this material body in Krishna consciousness so that immediately you will be transferred to the planet where Krishna is. That is the process. So, māmupesa, and if you can attain that situation, that is the perfection, that is the highest perfection of your life. Saṃsiddhīṁ paramāṁ. Paramāṁ means the highest. Highest perfection. Then, people may inquire, well, you say that to enter into the planet of Krishna is the highest perfection, but we are trying to enter into the moon planet. Is it not perfection? Somebody, you may question. Yes. In answer, this tendency to enter into the higher planets is always there in human mind. Don't think that we have advanced and we have invented this Sputnik for entering into the moon planet or sun planet. This tendency is always there. A living entity's name is Sarvaga. Sarvaga. He wants to travel everywhere. That is his nature. Just like you sometimes, you Americans, you go to India or Europe, you cannot stay stagnant at a place. That is our nature. So this tendency that we are trying to enter into the moon planet, this is not a new thing. They are trying, maybe by different process, by yoga process, by other process, everyone is trying to enter into the higher planets. So Krishna says, yes, you are trying to enter into the moon planet or any other planet, that's all right. But you must remember, what is that? Abrahma bhuvana lokana punaravartina arjuna. Abrahma bhuvana lokana. The universe is divided into 14 divisions of planetary system. 14 divisions. We are just in the middle planetary system. There are 14. Chaturdas bhuvan. There are 7 down and 7 up. We are in the middle. So Krishna says, the abrahma bhuvana loka. Oh, what we speak of moon planet or sun planet or Venus, if you even enter into the highest planet, which is called Brahma Loka, still there is birth and death, punaravartina, repetition of birth and death, repetition of birth. Punaravartina means just like I have got this body. Now, say I live 80 years. Now I'm 71. So after 9 years, I'll have to change this body. Sure. There is nobody can, by scientific process, can stay here. No. That is not allowed. You have to change your body. This is called punaravarti. Changing, just like you change your old dress, similarly, you have to change your old body. Again, enter into another new body. So this is called punaravarti. So Krishna says that if you enter in this material world, if you enter even to the highest planet, what to speak of this mool planet? Mool planet is just our neighbor. Your modern scientists have calculated that if we want to go to the highest planet, it will take the same speed of Sputnik, 20,000 miles per hour, still it will take 40,000 of years to reach the highest planet. That is the scientific view. But there is such planet where living entities like you and me are there. We have got this information from Bhagavad Gita and other Vedic literature. All planets, they're full of living entities. Don't think simply of the earth we are here as in all planets are vacant. No. From your experience you can see that no place in this earth is vacant without living entities. Even you dig earth, you'll find some worms. You go deep into the water, you'll find some living entities. You just analyze that outer space here, you'll find so many living entities. So how you can conclude that other planets are without living entities? They are all full of living entities. So Krishna says that in the Brahma Loka, in the highest planet of this universe, even if you enter there, Abrahma Bhuvana Lokana Punaravartina Arjuna. My dear Arjuna, if you enter even to the highest planet, still he will have to accept that repetition of birth and death. He cannot get rid of it. Mamupesta, again he says, as in the former verse, he says, Mamupesta, if you reach to my planet, then you haven't got to come back again in this miserable material world. Again he says repeatedly that if you enter into the highest planet of this universe, still your reputation of birth and death will continue. But Mamupesta, if you come to my planet, Mamupesta to Kauntya, Punarjanmana Vidyate. Oh, that same very thing is again confirmed here, Punarjanmana Vidyate. Oh, there is no more rebirth. No more, you get your eternal life. We should be very serious about this problem, how to get our eternal life blissful and full of knowledge. That is the duty of human life. We have forgotten this. What is our aim of life? Nate vidu sarthakatim hi Vishnu. They do not know that their interest, self-interest is how to get that eternal blissful life in the spiritual planet. That is his interest. Why they have forgotten durasayadi bhairathamanina? The people have been entrapped by this material glamour, by skyscraper and big factories and political activities. These are entrapped. Although he cannot leave, he knows that however skyscraper I may make, I will not be allowed to leave here. I will have to leave it. And I do not know where I am going. Therefore, the solution is that we should not spoil our energy for having a skyscraper. We should employ our energy to elevate ourselves to Krishna consciousness so that we can, after leaving this material body, we can enter into that spiritual path. That is the problem. So, Krishna consciousness is the necessity. It is not a religious formula or some spiritual recreation. No, it is the most important things that we should imbibe in our life. Mahamupetra. Mahamupetra tukumtiya punarjanmana vidyate. He is stressing again and again. Then you may ask, then why people are so much anxious to go to the other planet? The description of other planets is there also in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Now here it is said, the Brahma Loka, because there are many yogis and many philosophers, they aim at being elevated to the higher planets by their yogic process. Why? Because the facilities of life in the higher planets are more than in this planet. The duration of life, the enjoyment and the amenities and all. Everything is better, thousand times better, thousand times better. So, people like, somebody likes that we shall go to the heavenly planet or this planet, that planet. Now, some of the description of the higher planets is given here. What is that? Sahasra yugapadyantam marahajya brahmano vidu. Ratrim yuga sahasrantam te ahuratro vidu janaha. Now, here is a nice description of the highest planet of this universe. What is that? Now, sahasra yugapadyantam. Sahasra yuga means one yuga, means 43 lakhs of years. Then that means 4,300,000 of years. That is the duration of one jiva. And sahasra jiva, and sahasra means thousands. That is 4,300,000 of years. Just multiply it by another 1,000. Now we calculate. I am not a mathematician, you can calculate. What is that duration? That duration, long duration, 43 into 1,000. That means 43 50 again 30. Now, what is that duration? That is calculated to be 12 hours of Brahma. As you have got 12 hours from morning and 6 to evening 6. So, this duration of period in the Brahma Loka is 43 and 50 into 30. Just imagine. That is 12 hours. Similarly, another 12 hours night, same period. So that becomes one complete 24 hours of Brahma, Brahma Loka. And such 1 month, such 1 year, and 100 years duration of life is there. Sahasra yugapadyantam arahajyat brahmano vidu. That is the duration of life. You cannot calculate how long you can live there. But still, after so many years, millions and trillions of years, life, you'll have to die. Death is there. Death you cannot, unless you go into the spiritual planets, there is no escape from death. So, abrahma bhuvanando, abrahma yugapadyantam, sahasra yugapadyantam, arhajyat brahmano vidu, ratrin yuga sahasrantam te ahoratra vidu jana. Abhaktyat bhaktayo sarva, prabhavanti ahoragame. Now, this duration of Brahma, the material manifestation in the lower status, this planetary system, when Brahma, as days is finished, all this planetary system becomes covered in water. There is devastation. Devastation. And when again Brahma, the supreme person in the Brahma Loka, he rises up, then again creation begins. That is the law of creation. So, Abhaktat bhaktiya sattva pravanti ahuragame. Aha, aha means in the daytime. When there is daytime, they can tell us, then this material manifestation, what you see, all these planets, they are manifested, they are seen. But when there is night time, all this planetary system becomes merged into devastation of water. So, ratragami priyante tatraiva abhakta sangame. Ratragami means when the night is there, then again all these planets become invisible. They are divided within the water. This is the nature of this material world. Bhutagrama saivayam bhuttarutapaliya. So, because the whole planetary system become merged into devastation of water, therefore all living entities, they at that time, prolay, devastation, they all die. Bhutagrama saivayam bhuttarutapaliya. So this nature is going on. When it is the daytime, they are again coming out, and when there is night time, they again all become swans into this water. Ratragame avasa pratha prabhavati ahuragame avasa. Avasa means, although they do not like devastation, the devastation will come and say, overflood all this. And again, when the day of sun, again gradually, the waters will disappear. Just like in this planet, the three-four is covered with water, and gradually land is coming out. It takes time. And one day it will come when there will be no water, simply land. There will be no water. That is the process of nature. Parastasmātu bhāvanya. Parastasmātu bhāvanya abhakta bhaktya sanātana. But my dear Arjuna, beyond this place, sometimes it is appearing, sometimes it is disappearing. Beyond this, there is another nature. Just take this information from Bhagavad Gita. We cannot calculate what is the length and breadth of this universe. But there are millions and millions of universes like this within this material world. And above this material world, there is another sky, which is called spiritual sky. And in that sky, the planets are all eternal, and their life is eternal. This manifestation, this material manifestation, is only 3/4 part of the whole manifestation, both spiritual and material. You'll find in the Bhagavad Gita. Ekāṃsi nasthitu jagat. Ekāṃsi means 1/4 part. These manifestations are 1/4 part. And 3/4 part manifestation is beyond this material sky. This material sky is covered. When you see to the sky, you find that ball-like covering. That is the covering. So, millions and millions of miles, the covering is there. And after penetrating that covering, you can enter into the spiritual sky. That is open sky. So here you get the information that parastasmātu bhāva anya. Bhāva means nature, another nature. Just like you have got experience of this material nature. Similarly, there is another, a spiritual nature. Just like the material nature and spiritual nature, you have got experience here also. What is that? Just like you are yourself combination of material and spiritual. You are yourself spirit. So long you are within this body, within this matter, it is moving. And as long, as soon as you are out of this body, it is as good as stone. So as you can perceive here, within yourself, what is matter, one is spirit. Similarly, there is a spiritual world also. The two natures are there. has, you can experience two natures here, the material nature and spiritual nature. This we have discussed in the 7th chapter of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. The spiritual nature is called superior nature, and this material nature is called inferior nature. So, this material nature, beyond this material nature, there is a superior nature, spiritual nature. This information we have got. Now, it is not possible but to understand these things by experimental knowledge. Just like, although you are seeing by microscope and other instruments, astronomical instruments, there are millions and millions of stars, actually you are seeing, but you cannot approach. Your senses, your means are so insufficient that you cannot approach. What to speak of other planets, you cannot approach even the moon planet, which is the nearest. So just try to understand how much incapable you are. So being incapable, don't try to understand God and God's kingdom by experimental knowledge. This is foolishness. It is not possible. You have to understand by hearing Bhagavad Gita, and there is no other way. That's the same example. You cannot understand who is your father by experimental knowledge. You have to simply believe your mother. Similarly, you have to believe this Bhagavad Gita, then you can get all this knowledge. There is no possibility of experimental knowledge. But if you become advanced in Krishna consciousness, you realize. Just like whatever we are speaking, we are firmly convinced. We are not blindly speaking. So you also will. Same vasurato. This knowledge will be revealed to you. If you stick to the Krishna consciousness, this knowledge, you will actually understand, yes, there is spiritual kingdom, there is God, and I have to go there, and I must prepare there, just like you understand everything while you go to some other country. So these are all practical things. If you take out this Krishna consciousness, the problem of your life is solved. Thank you very much.